Okay, so the so Soloveitchik says the following. He says we spoke about the fact that when you're doing vidui for averus ben adam le makom, that's a private, that's an intimate experience. That's not an experience that you need to share with anybody else. But when it comes to doing vidui on the averus that ben adam le chavero, so then there is a need to do it in a public forum, because the breakdown of the relationship with the other person has often been done in some type of public space. So therefore, it's appropriate that is done in the vidui is also done, as he says, lifnei habriot, in front of people. Zot va'od acheret anu shomim min alim. This and there's something else that we learn from those words lifnei ha'el baruchu. Remember, the whole point was that the Rav Soloveitchik is pointing out that the Rambam used these four extra words. So he says that the one idea is that you've got to do the vidui. The other thing is the following. It's not only that the vidui has to be before HaKadosh Baruch Hu, ela afa tshuva atzma. Even the tshuva itself needs to be lifnei HaKadosh Baruch Hu. So he says, what does it mean? Ba'od shebeperek aleph, halocha aleph. In Perek Aleph, Halocha Aleph, that's the first halocha, the introduction to Hilchos Tshuva, the Rambam says, "V'chayav litvadot lifnei el Baruch Hu," that there's the chiyuv to do vidui before Hashem. Harei mudgash b'perek bet, but in the second Perek, in Halocha Hay, the Rambam says, "V'shav lifnei el Baruch Hu." So you've got, on the one hand, you've got, it introduces us with the concept of vidui lifnei Hashem, and then later on, it speaks about v'shav tshuva lifnei Hashem. Lichoira ma shach l'ma b'tshuva lifnei el. So he says, what does it mean to do tshuva before Hashem? In b'vidui ne'emar lifnei el kadei l'kasher et avidui b'tvila. We can understand vidui connecting to before HaKadosh Baruch Hu in order to maintain a certain relationship and connection between vidui and tvila and davening. Klumi tachen ches tshuva shebelev. So, I mean, how else would there be tshuva? Tshuva must be belayed. Lifnei mi yashuva adam. Obviously, who else are you going to do tshuva in front of? Im lo lifnei el, if not doing before Hashem. Like, one does tshuva because one wants to fix your relationship with Hashem. So who else would you do the tshuva in front of? But lama afor madgish Rambam v'shav lifnei el baruchu. So how come the Rambam enters the concept of doing tshuva lifnei ha'el baruchu? So just to summarize what he's saying is that the Rambam spoke about vidui lifnei Hashem, he speaks about tshuva lifnei Hashem. Doesn't make any sense for him to emphasize the concept of tshuva lifnei Hashem, says Rav Soloveitchik, at least not on a superficial level. Doesn't make sense, because who else are you going to do the tshuva in front of? So, gam benusach avidui shel kohen gadol, even in the nusach of the vidui, of the kohen gadol, nusach hanahug lifnei Rambam b'chol avidui, which is the nusach that we are supposed to have in all the viduis that we do. It says, Ana Hashem, which we understand, Ana, Chatati avitu pashati lefanecha. I did all of these things, all the transgressions, all the various types, lefanecha, in front of you. So, HaGemara sapra, umanta kol mila umila shebevidui. So, and the Gemara counts each word of the vidui. V'hivya mikraot la'ashesh makoma shekol mila. And it brings proof from the psukim for each one of these different words, right? Chatati, aviti, pashati, mistaber, shenusach avidui, humidoraisa. So it would seem to be, therefore, that the way the Rav Soloveitchik presents it, that the actual nusach, the formulation of the words of the vidui, may in fact be midoraisa from the Torah. Yesha fol asim lev lehavin, says, and therefore you have to really think about the fact, Lama nivchara kan amila lefanecha. Why does it have to say in the vidui, chatati, pashirti, avitu, lefanecha, in front of you, HaKadosh Baruch Hu? So he says, you could say, in Hebrew, you could say, if shalomar, chatati lefanecha, you could say that I sinned in front of you, if shalomar, chatati lach, or you could say, I sinned to you. So you can say it in a way, the way you say, I send in front of you, or I can say, I send to you. Kach omar Yehuda la'aviv. And that's what Yehuda, the son of Yaakov, said to his father. He says, im lo hevi yosiv, He says when Yehuda takes on himself, we know, to be achrayi, to be responsible for the safety of Binyamin in going down to Mitzrayim. Yaakov wants him, Yosef wants him there. Yaakov doesn't want to send him. We know Reuven makes the most ridiculous proposition that if something happens to Binyamin, then Yaakov can kill his two sons. That didn't really work for Yaakov for obvious reasons. Reuven says, okay, im lo hevi yativ, if I do not bring him back to you, v'chatati lecha kol hayamim, then it will be considered as if I have v'chatati lecha, I've sinned to you all the days of my life. But nusach havidui shel mi shechata lechaver v'meit. So what? And there's a nusach of vidui that a person says in front of a person. If a person has wronged their friend, and that person passes away, but they haven't yet done any type of tshuva and they haven't fixed that relationship up. So says the says Rav Soloveitchik, there is a specific nusach that the Rambam brings, and he says, "Vayomer bifnehem chatasi laHashem Elohi Yisrael v'liploni zeh," that I send laHashem, to Hashem, and to this person. So it's clear that the concept of vidui can either use the word lefanecha or use the word le. Mikan itan lamod al avchana lashonit. Lefanecha. It seems to be, therefore, we learn that when you say the word lefanecha, that's only rak klapei Elohim. That's only in front of HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Whereas lach is when it includes man and HaKadosh Baruch Hu. So what's the difference, says Rav Soloveitchik? Chatati lach perusho. His hazakatilach garamtilach hefset. He says, you know what? The thing is, when you say lach, he says, I've caused you something. I've caused you damage. Ani chayav lecha mashu. I owe you something. Like Yehuda said, he owed before his father. Bitui zeh matim lechasim shebein bnei Adam. Says this concept of that I've done something to you is because when we do something to somebody, then there is it's an issue in the relationship. It breaks down the relationship. And according to Yiddishkeit, and also when we do something incorrect or inappropriate in our relationship with HaKadosh Baruch Hu, then that also does some damage in that relationship. Cheta Adam, he says now, so beautiful. Cheta Adam, the sin of a pure person, harehu dochek bakach raglei hashchina. When a person does an aver, you know what you do? You push aside the legs of the Shekhinah. You push aside the balance, what the Shekhinah has in this world. So to speak, if you could possibly say such a thing, you damage the integrity of Hashem's presence in this world. Not you, we. Sorry. Adam eino yachol livgoa ve'in ein sof baruch hu. Obviously, we can't damage HaKadosh Baruch Hu, the ein sof. Ein sof means there's no end to it. The HaKadosh Baruch Hu is everything. You can't damage it in a real way. We're saying, so to speak, Shehu lo eile mikol chushpana, because HaKadosh Baruch Hu is beyond anything. Kashem she'eno yachol heitiv lo. In the same way as that we can't do things good for Hashem. You know, you can't take Hashem a cake because you just want to say thank you for the things that he does. V'im yitzlak ma'yitein lach, what can we possibly do? Olam kashem istaklim al Hashem, kalavini shebashamayim. However, when we look and we view HaKadosh Baruch Hu as Avinu Shebashamayim, as our Father in heaven, midyachasim elav kaHashem tzali al yad yimini, and we relate to HaKadosh Baruch Hu as this energy that is there right with us on with our right hand, constantly being part of our lives. Kol ema shebaim levakeish panav lishov mimenu nachama veidud azay kashichot im dochkim et ragle hashchina. Right, so it says then, when we are able to connect with HaKadosh Baruch Hu all the time, that we come and to ask him for his nechama, for his connection, then HaKadosh Baruch Hu feels the pain. When we see HaKadosh Baruch Hu as Avinu Shebashamayim, as our Father in heaven, we see him in this deep connection. When we come because we've done something wrong, he feels the pain of a parent feeling the pain of a child. And then, when we do something wrong, we mafsid, so to speak, we damage the Shekhinah process, we damage the Shekhinah relation. Mishum kach, therefore it says, Yitachem nomar chatasi laHashem elohi Yisrael v'lach. Therefore, we can say, I've sinned to our Kodesh Baruch Hu and lach, and to and to the person. So when we do an avera ben adam lechaveiro, we can understand that the avera damages the relationship with the person, and it also damages the relationship with HaKadosh Baruch Hu. So therefore, we'll carry on, please God, tomorrow with the concept of what it means, katati lefanecha. We've seen lach. Lach is on a personal relationship, the damaging. What does lefanecha mean? Please God, we'll see it tomorrow. Have a wonderful day, everybody.
Thank you.